Hello friends, welcome to my class. And today we are going to study how to design lesson plan for English grammar. And that is on your screen. So friends, here on the screen is the lesson plan of English grammar. As you can see on the top of your screen, the same entries are here, which we have already discussed in our previous lesson plan. So we will start from date, the date when you are teaching this particular lesson plan, the class in which you are teaching, that class's section, period which you are taking, then time, which should be approximately from 30 to 45 minutes. Subject, here you need to specify, as you can see here on this part, I have specified English grammar. So you also have to specify which subject you are taking today. So today we are studying grammar. So I have written English grammar over here. And at the last, and the extreme right hand side of this table, there is topic, and today we are going to study about adjective. Now the second point, name of the school that you are assigned, general objectives. These objectives are again for long period of time, say for 1 year or 2 year, and these are on your screen: to make students acquainted with the rules of English grammar, to enable them to command and master in the English language, to help the pupils to transfer the rules of grammar in their study course, to develop logical and thinking power in the students. And this cannot happen overnight, so it will take a long period of time, say for 1 year or 2 year. Then is your specific objectives. Specific objectives are framed on the basis of Bloom's taxonomy. So these are knowledge, understanding, application, and interest. On the knowledge part, the student will get knowledge about adjective. This is your focus, this is your aim or objective for today. So as you enter the class today and you are teaching adjective, you have this objective in your mind that today student shall get the knowledge of adjective. Okay, at understanding level, the student will understand the adjectives and their uses. So first they will know, and then they will understand. When they will understand, then they will be able to apply it. So in application part, the students will try to make effective use of adjective in speaking and writing, and this is what we want. In fourth point, which is interest, the students will take interest in English grammar. And finally, at the last, at the bottom of this page, there is material aid used, which are in form of pictures, charts, roller board, chalk, duster, and other classroom equipments. Now let's skip to another page, which starts with previous knowledge. Now here, just try to recall Herbertian theory. He says that the knowledge is already inside the student, we just have to take it out on the threshold. And this part, especially here, it does the same work. When we are asking questions to the students, we are taking the knowledge that is embedded out on the surface. So we will start with introductory questions. Here again there is a table with three columns. We will start with extreme left hand side, that is pupil teacher activity, then students activity, and then finally on extreme right is teaching aids. On this particular side you can see a green colored part. This is actually on the chart paper. So when you are in your schools, you should paste these type of examples on the chart paper. You should write on the chart paper or just cut it and paste it there. The first question raised by teacher is, what is the subject in this first sentence? So here the teacher will be pointing out to the chart paper, reading these examples. So it may be that a teacher is reading, or you can allow students to read it. So the student will read, Ruchi is a good girl. The teacher will ask, what is the subject in first sentence? And the student will react, Ruchi is the subject in first sentence. Because before starting the concept of, or before giving the knowledge about adjective, it is essential for students to know about subject, predicate, noun, pronoun. These are the simple concepts that they must know. So without prior knowledge of all these topics, we cannot start adjective. So what teacher is trying to do? Teacher is trying to recall the knowledge. And students are answering the questions. What is Ruchi in English grammar? So the students will answer, Ruchi is noun in English grammar. Again, teacher poses a question, what is subject in second sentence? That means teacher will allow students to read second sentence. And the students will answer, she is the subject in second sentence. What is beautiful in English grammar? Now you can see this last sentence written on the chart where it is written, rose is a beautiful flower. Now they have answered noun, pronoun, subject, predicate because they know it. But when it is asked about beautiful, they will be confused. And generally, it will be a problematic question for them. If they know, they will answer that, sir, it is adjective. And if they do not know, some students are very sharp, so they will answer. This will happen with you. And if it is not, then what you are going to do? This is problematic question for you. And from here onwards, you are going to start your statement of aim. So students, today we shall study about adjective. Now let's come to the presentation part. Again, it is a table over here with the 6 columns starting from serial number ending up to evaluation. At the first point is presentation of example, and what expected behavior outcome is that students will be able to read and write English. This is read and write English. So here what we are going to do is we are just allowing students to read or to write. Okay, so what teacher is doing? The teacher will present a chart with some sentences written on it. Again, on this right hand side, you can see this colored paper over here. This is actually in your chart paper. So the teacher will present chart with some examples or sentences written on it. And what a student is doing? The student will look at the chart and listen attentively. So what is focused? Reading and writing is focused here. Okay, so nobody is allowed to write at this time. You must remember that students are not allowed to write when you are teaching. Only they will be allowed when you ask them to write. Okay, so here the second point is observation and analysis of the examples. So what a student is doing here? What a student is expected to do? The student will recall and recognize the sentence. The sentences that you have asked previously written on this part, they will try to recall and recognize these sentences. Now, the pupil teacher will ask some questions like, what is the coat in English grammar? The first sentence you can see, the man in black coat is my uncle. So, taking this sentence, you'll frame a question, what is the coat in English grammar called? So, the coat is a thing in English grammar. Okay, what is the color of the coat? Now the answer will come, it is black in color. What is the word Nainital in grammar code? Now they are very smart, they will answer, Nainital is noun in grammar. So can you see this sequence? First, we are asking about noun, that is thing or a city, and then we are asking about its quality or what's written about it. So for example, for coat, it is written that it is black in color. And for Nainital, it is written that it is a beautiful city. So we are relating the idea that there is a thing or there is a place which we call as noun, and it is related to its quality, that the thing is black or the city is very beautiful. So the thing, noun, and its quality. So the sequence comes here, and yet another questions will be asked. And this particular method is called as question answer method. And at last, what does the word, question number 7, what does the word black, beautiful, faithful, truth and non-violence indicate? Now this is again a mind-blowing, you know, question for them. What do these indicate? Yes, of course, they indicate the quality of the noun. So the answer will come from students. If they are not able to answer, then you will provoke them to answer. Okay? Now let's skip to the third point, that is generalization. And generalization is always after you have linked the idea of noun with quality. Okay, so the students will be able to generalize and construct the rules. Noun and its quality. The pupil teacher will generalize and write on the blackboard. Here you have to use blackboard. You have to pick up your chalk and write this definition directly on the board. The word which qualifies noun or pronoun is called adjective. For example, wise, good, pretty, poor, etc. You can give other examples too. In point number 4, it is drill and application. So here, students are expected that students will make obligatory use of adjective. What pupil teacher is doing here? Pupil teacher will ask some questions. For example, what is good in English grammar? What is tall in English grammar? The students will answer the question because already they have generalized. It is assumed that in previous part or in previous teaching points, the concept has been generalized. So they will be able to answer these questions. Now, finally, friends, let's skip to the last part, that is blackboard summary. And here, as you can see, it is a black piece of paper. And similarly, you have to do in your note copies also. You have to cut a black chart paper and with silver pen, you have to write and you have to fill all the entries. As such, you can see in this piece of paper. And finally, the classroom supervision. This already we have discussed that pupil teacher will make a round in the class and ensure whether students are writing or not. And you have to assign some homework also in form of short questions, fill in the blanks or multiple choice questions also. So finally, you have to write reference book. It is the name of that book from which you have taken this particular lesson. Here we have finished the lesson plan of grammar. Thank you so much. So here friends, we have discussed how to design lesson plans in English grammar. You can also frame your own lesson plans. Thank you so much for watching this.